Hello, welcome to this video. Let's see quickly how to make 3D objects and apply 3D effects with CorelDRAW X7. Leave us comments to give us feedbacks if you can. All you need to create 3D objects is inside a tool called the Extrude tool. Keep in mind that this tool works on vector curves only. If you try it on paragraphs or bitmap images, nothing will happen. If you want to know how to make 3D text, watch the related video in this guide. Let's suppose to add the extrusion to an ellipse. Enable the Extrude tool and click and drag on the object. Then you can drag the big cross to change the extrusion direction and move the small rectangle in the middle to edit the extrusion length. As you can see, if you start from a transparent vector curve, also its extrusion will be transparent. You will need to add some filling color to the initial curve to cover its extrusion fully. If you click once again on the object while the Extrude tool is active, you will be able to apply 3D rotation on the object. Drag on the green arrows to rotate around the direction. Drag on the object to rotate in full 3D. Click once on the object to finish. You can delete this effect by clicking on Clear Extrusion above, when the tool is on. Mind that the 3D object you created is always a 2D object, according to the software. In fact, if you apply any gradient or pattern on the object, this will be distributed on the same way on both object and extrusion. To personalize your object without losing its 3D shape, you need to use the extrude options on top that appear when the extrude tool is on. To make all fast, you can use the presets on the extreme left. Next to the position values, you can change the kind of extrusion. The small icon says how it works. The rectangle with bold contours is the initial curve you start from. The extrusion is all not in bold. Next to this icon, you can choose the position of the bold cross that decides the extrusion direction. More on the right, choose the extrusion length and other graphic options. The first icon is the 3D rotation, as seen before. The object is indicated with a pixelated 3. When you don't see it in 3D, it means that you didn't apply any 3D rotation on the object. To rotate, just click and drag on the 3. Undo any 3D rotation by clicking on the small undo arrow in the bottom left corner of the window. The second icon sets the extrusion color. You can choose to cover it with the same kind of filling that the 2D curve has. Applying a non-solid color or a good gradient made of two colors. If you search for a particular color, you can use the eyedropper tool. Click on the color you want first, and then click on the face or contour you want to fill. This is useful if you want to get rid of lines you don't want to show. The third icon is used to add any bevel. Try it. The last icon is used to adjust lightness. You can add different light sources and adjust each of their position and strength. Just activate and deactivate them on the left. What happens if you apply 2D effects on this extruded object? These effects will always work on the original 2D curve. So if the curve is changed, the extrude will be adjusted, following the new shape. Other effects may not work properly. If you use the drop shadow tool, this will work on the curve only. You can apply shadow on both curve and extrusion if you group them. Just select both of them, right-click, and go to group objects. If you try to apply shadow again, this will include the curve and the extrusion shape. To ungroup objects, just right-click and go to ungroup objects. There are other 3D effects you can find in CorelDRAW X7. If you go to effects and then to add perspective, you can set different points of view. This effect can be applied on curves and vectors only. You can apply 3D effects on your images as well. Select one and go to bitmaps and then to 3D effects. You can apply emboss, 3D rotation and perspective. Try them. Thanks for watching this video. Check our channel to discover more.